Welcome to War Mode.
Not one of the good white people. There are no good white people. There are only anti-racist white people and racist white people.
Raised the black church, he knows I'm not kidding.
I got my education for real in the black church.
Oh Lord, leaving my doctor office, child. Oh Lord, it's rough out here. I'm dealing with this arthritis.
Big believer, never giving up. Never giving up, no matter what comes your way. But sometimes, when enough is enough.
They were passing around butt plugs and dildos to my students, talking about queer sex, using lube versus using spit.
Meet Joe Bruno, Dean of Students at the prestigious Francis W. Parker Private School in Chicago.
Oh, my mother can't tell me nothing. I'm a grown man. I can do anything I want.
The bill chips the three nano chips. The three nano chip. Chips and the three nano. You know what I'm saying? Nano, no, no. I don't know.
Spell red.
Red? L-S-T-E-R.
All right, is that your final answer?
My final answer.
So what would you do right now in Ukraine if you were the president?
Putin uses the N-word. I call it the N-word. He uses the N-word all the time. That's a no-no. You're not supposed to do that. He uses it on a daily basis.
I mean, I couldn't believe it. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. That's what 6 million looks like. Insane.
I stated that this is a complicated as fuck topic, at least to me it is.
This was the no-brainer. This was the banker. This was the one that couldn't fail. This was one that's never failed.
I need to know that I have done one thing right with my life.
I can't help it, boy. But act like you goddamn real, nigga.
Happen again in history. There will never be a situation where people end a multi-billion dollar deal off of a tweet. Gotcha. So I would like to thank everyone that was involved with this negotiation. Thank God no one was hurt in the process. And I feel free!
Dude, if I could... Oh, why the fuck is it doing this? Oh, we're good. Yeah, if I could get an exoskeleton, I fucking would.
Yeah.
I felt it the minute I put those weights on the ground. I just felt this jolt, and I was like, this is game the fuck over. I know it for a fact. I've been here before. But, yeah.
Oh, were we before?
Yeah, that Sam Britton guy is fucking bizarre. If he is actually a troll, like, that would faze me.
Oh, no, not that guy. They said the other...
What other guy?
Another person. I'll tell you later.
Oh, okay, yeah. I thought you were talking about this Sam Britton guy.
No, no, different guy.
Oh, okay, yeah. Because this dude is just doing the weird. Like, he's just out stealing shit from people.
Not everybody's okay, man.
Yeah, this dude. It's weird they're all into bondage, though. It's like, this dude's way against conversion therapy. It's like, bro, if you're fucking tying up your friends.
He's a rope bunny. I've encountered these things in the wild.
That's a sick fucking Jones to have.
Yeah.
Especially, like, if something goes bad.
I do enjoy knots. I had a book on knots a long time ago, but I can't get into this. I can't get into tying boobs up. It's not my stuff.
Turn them fucking purple and shit.
It's not my stuff.
Dude, I know way too much shit about Nancy Pelosi now, and it's fucking pissing.
Oh, did you watch it?
Bro, it'll like, for a normal human to watch that and feel good about politics blows my mind. Like, she sits there and like watches herself become a meme, and it's her reacting, becoming a meme of like the clap she did to Trump, and then she's imitating the clap, and then they're all showing Nancy Pelosi, who's like borderline probably shitting herself. Her pussy's probably a mess. Like, it's probably shit, piss, grilled cheese shit, like all fucking caked up in there, and she's just like having a ball, happy as fuck. Like, her daughter recorded the whole thing. Like, all the footage that is from that documentary is from her daughter, who Lord knows what the fuck she does. Like,
right.
And it's just like showing you how much of a badass she is. They go through like her. I mean, I watched the PBS documentary. I'm a bit of a fucking fan.
That's your girlfriend.
Not my girlfriend. Not my type at all. She was hot at one point in her life.
You're into chest. You're into chest, and you know that. Stop. Don't do that.
I mean, find me a guy who isn't into big naturals. I'll find you a liar, dude. It's in our fucking DNA, dude. It's where the life force comes out. Yeah, it was a very, very bad thing to watch. And the whole time, they just try to make her into like some like real badass chick. And like, she's in a meeting with Mike Pence on the phone during COVID. And the whole time she's like doing her laundry, not paying attention. It's on mute the whole time. She's like, I don't care. Am I a bitch for doing this? I don't care. It's like all the taxpayer, like trillions of dollars of bills getting spent. And this chick's just doing her laundry. Could give a fuck less. The best part of the whole fucking thing is Paul Pelosi is a character from Trailer Park Boys. Like if you watch this dude's daily shit, he is 100% that you could put him in Trailer Park Boys. Yeah. I would not flinch at all. He's just like, dude, he was at some fundraiser, just slouched on a fucking like table. He really is. Like he's always fucked up. Like she's on the phone with Mike Pence. He's just scraping a plate of fucking shit and picking it up. Like Nancy's laughing because they hate fucking Pence, which I also do, but for other reasons.
What are your thoughts on Trump's NFTs?
I mean, you want to like a guy, dude. And I know NFTs are a sore subject, but if you have a brain cell left, buy, 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 buy. Get Trump's NFTs. They're going to be worried. Why did he start doing this?
I have no idea. I just saw it. I just saw like a headline on my phone.
Yeah, supposedly he said he had like a real big announcement and just hit him with the NFTs. If boomers get into NFTs, I'm going to fucking die.
I think that's what it is.
He just, like someone just called his ear about this?
I don't know, but I'm saying like you can mock it and laugh all you want, but this would be boomers getting an NFT. They didn't get the other ones.
What, crypto?
The younger, like the fucking tiki torches and all that stuff. They didn't get that.
Turn up tikis.
they didn't buy that stuff. You could get boomers on Trump's ones.
He had this whole thing like it was going to come out with a crazy ass thing. He just hit him with the NFT.
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck it's for.
He probably thinks it's fucking nuclear.
I mean, it probably is. Yeah. Like if you like they're all way too fucking old. Which I don't like trust any of these dudes, but like these guys are like I'm watching that Nancy Pelosi documentary. Like this chick's old as fuck. Like she shouldn't be able to fucking drive. And they're all there in the fucking in Capitol Hill.
They're not doing anything. Balls,
dude. Like they're very old and like they're not doing hot. Like all of their husbands are kind of drunk. They're all cheating on each other. Chuck Schumer's a fucking rat, dude. That dude's voice just pisses me the fuck off.
Yeah, and I can't click on it. I can't watch any of that stuff. All I've been freaking out about is like psyops, my own mental health, the mental health of others, trying to get through what I think all this PR shit is, like all this that you're watching. Pull up HBO. It's Pelosi. It's Shaq.
They killed me when they put that Shaq doc up, bro.
It's Shaq, dude. It's fucking Richard Branson.
That's crazy.
These are all people that are compromised. Yeah, he said Shaq's compromised.
I mean, dude, if he said that and then HBO put that up, he's probably not lying. Like, Shaq is a cleanup guy. Papa John's fucked up, dude. He slipped up on a fucking phone call. Shaq gets Papa John's.
It's pretty crazy. It's just like my wheels start spinning, and I'm like, all right, dude, this is just fifth generation warfare, 5G warfare.
Yeah.
And you don't know who the enemy is. Like, this shit will fuck you up. This stuff, like, these kind of psyops, it's like a bunch of, this is what the French talks about, the quantum state.
Yeah.
So it's a bunch of people that have an interest. Like, just for instance, just take, like, Pfizer and, like, one of the bigger companies that owns the media corporations.
Yeah.
They'll squad up. They're just doing a project together.
The money changers.
The money changers. Don't get me into the Fed. But the money changers will decide that they're going to run something on the American population.
Yeah.
Because we're now, like, I kind of thought the internet was for fun. And I thought that it was fun.
It's like thinking free porn's good for you, dude.
Yeah, like, I was having a good time, and I was like, oh, wow, everything's going good. And me and Billy are trying to make money on the internet. And then I didn't realize that this is a battlefield.
Yeah.
And we're being attacked.
On all fronts, probably. You had me thinking about that, like how treacherous the internet is and like how hard they're psyoping you. But I mean, dude, imagine just, and I have my own
thoughts. It's all civilians, though. This war is all civilians. There's no soldiers. Like, they have psyop battalions.
Yeah.
And there's dudes that are proud. Like, their badges are fucking insane. I'll try to find a picture of the badges. Dude, like, you know how, like, if you are part of, like, a special forces, they come up with, like, a little pin for you?
Yeah.
I'll try to find it.
Oh, Italy's, like, PSYOP has a PSYOP force?
No, not Italy, America.
Oh, we do.
Yeah, we have PSYOP battalions.
Holy shit. Well, for some reason, I thought you were talking about Italy.
It says persuade, change, and influence on it.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? This might be the IDF. The IDF are really good at this.
Is that Ireland?
Yeah, they fought a. Yeah, Matt was telling me about the money changers trying to fucking. Like knock them down. And I was like, yo, are the Irish guys?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, the persuade, change, and influence. It's fucking insane.
It's like, crazy that's their, that's a branch of the military.
That's a branch of the military now because this is the new generation of warfare. So, like, you can look at all the old ones, like first gens, just like melee weapons, rocks.
Yeah.
And then.
But like, when did they get into that was World War II? They started giving all the crazy, like, girls can smoke stuff.
There's always been psyops, but like, what it's going on, like, it's on another level now. Like, I would have to like stop and show you a thing on the computer screen.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about, though. You're saying it's on another level. I think they just have to do way, way more because it used to be Cronkite. So you could trick a whole entire population into going to war, everything. Now they need all this shit out on the internet because the truth is coming out hardcore.
Yeah, can you pause it for a second?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man. I'm just like fucking out of it. This is going to be really hard for me. Yeah, so you got ancient melee battle.
True.
Made
My
irrelevant.
Ancestors were probably there.
Made irrelevant by muskets. Then organized battle with gunpowder. That's World War One.
Yeah.
But then that stopped being a thing with blitzkriegs.
Yeah.
That was World War Two. And then terrorism, the third generation is blitzkrieg.
Yeah.
And then insurgencies start popping up. And that's fourth gen. That's like Vietnam.
It's terrorist.
Right? It's like terrorists and stuff. And then people kind of thought there's like a couple of dudes, there's this guy Lind, and there's some other guys that wrote books about this. And they kind of, some people are saying that we're still in fourth gen.
Yeah.
But then there's other people that are like, dude, what we're dealing with now is something that is a new form of warfare. We, since the internet came about, and like we are all like casualties.
It's a war for your mind.
Yes, exactly. It really is. And you have to protect your weapon. Yeah. You have to protect your mind.
Dude,
and it's fucking terrifying because what they're pushing is mass social engineering, and they're getting it done.
Very well.
And I got freaked out when I was listening to Ed talk about how there's legitimate NPCs that don't have inner monologue in their minds. And apparently this went viral like 2 years ago.
Started asking around about that too.
Apparently this is a thing. Like, I don't know how this could be a thing. This is kind of going to be blowing my mind if this is a thing.
I mean, I wonder if like that's why some people get on psych meds. Like, I have voices in my head. It's like, dude, yeah.
Well, I legitimately have voices in my head.
Yeah.
And this has been a problem since I was a little kid.
Yeah.
Running a vacuum.
Dude, I can't do that, by the way.
What?
If I'm fucking, like, I was putting a pocket door in last night, and when I'm drilling, you just start hearing shit.
Well, do you hear voices?
Voices, thinking people are going to fucking pop around the corner. Like, I'm fucked. If there's the vacuum's on or anything, I'm just like, dude, it's like something's up here.
Yeah, well. You know, allegedly some dude from, I don't know if it's MIT or Harvard or whatever, but in the 70s started doing it might be Las Vegas. I don't know, dude. My head's gone. I'm sorry, bro.
It was in America.
Listen, somewhere this guy studied this and a bunch of people don't.
Swear to God.
They can't talk to themselves in their head. They can't practice conversations. They can't think in paragraphs. They can't like think in sentences.
Dude,
I can't believe
that.
I know it's hard, dude. But I didn't know face blindness was a thing. I found out some people are face blind.
Yeah, dude, I can get that though. But like to not like you're talking.
Like I can't get that face blind. Think about that. You can't tell the difference between people's faces. That's fucking wild.
Yeah, but at least you're thinking about it. Like to not have a thought in your head. Like I always thought there was like a few dudes out there.
Yeah,
a lot of them cut concrete for a living. I have no fucking idea. Like,
well, dude, I'm telling you, like if you start thinking about they're coming out with all this AI. They keep talking AI, and we are in a new form of warfare.
Yes.
And if you know going into it, this is what Pasio talks about. Like the occult, they understand psychology more than you. Big time. Walking onto a chessboard, and like you don't know it. They're playing chess with you. We're all pawns.
Dude, I'm starting to get fucking recommendations for dark psychology.
Yes, dude.
Dude, it's the weirdest dudes on the planet. Like, if you, like, the one thing it was saying, like, if you're talking to someone, tell them, oh, yeah, I was going to, you know what, never mind, I'm not going to say. It's like, then you have them on a string. It's like, bro, if you're looking this far into conversations, you might want to chill the fuck out a little bit.
So you think this is, like, a thing that's, like, people are watching and trying to take tips for like conversations.
Oh yeah.
Oh, weird.
Yeah, it's fucking bizarre.
Yeah, so what I was going to say was like when they do this fifth generation stuff, you don't know who the enemy is. So, like, do you remember when Trump was like, we're fighting an invisible enemy? And they're like, do you really consider yourself a wartime president? And he's like, yeah, we were out. Like, dude.
Do I remember waiting for each fucking COVID address every fucking day, dude? Yeah. Obviously. You said we're fighting invisible enemy. I thought there was fucking little kids coming out from under.
Yeah, I was trying to talk to the French about it, but I watched that Banshees of Inisherin movie with Brendan Gleeson.
Oh, yeah, the one you're talking about.
Yeah, and in the movie, the guy just, like, tells the other dude to fuck off because he's dim and he's dull. So, like, I watched this thing. I'm in a deep, dark psyop of, like, not knowing if I can actually function anymore. So I'm hanging on by a thread here. And then I'm watching this movie, and this dude's just, like, he's, like, he thinks it's his best friend. Like, of all times, like, for me going through my own problems, like, I'm watching this movie, and, like, this guy, Colin Farrell, thinks he's best friends with Brendan Gleeson, and Brendan Gleeson goes, I don't want to talk to you anymore. I'm done with you.
You're too dumb.
You're too dim, you know?
Holy fuck.
And, like, it sends this dude into a tailspin because he just can't figure it the fuck out. Like, he's like, you can't just not be friends with somebody anymore.
Yeah,
anyway, the general, fucking Brendan Gleeson, he's in this movie called The General. Goat-ass fucking movie.
That was a good movie.
But, I wanted to talk to the French about it, but then I was like, I just kept feeling like, in the movie, Brendan Gleeson's like a kind of like an intellectual type dude.
Yeah.
And Colin Farrell's just like a fun dude to hang out with.
Yeah.
So, and Brendan Gleeson's like, dude, I can't waste any more time in my life talking to you.
I couldn't imagine being that smart.
That's what I'm saying. The French is standing there and, like, I'm talking to him. He's writing a paper on, he's teaming up with Japan and the United States State Department.
Yeah.
To go write a paper about an embargo that they ran on China in the lead up of World War II.
Yes.
And he's also writing a book on quantum states. And I'm like sitting on the floor, I'm like sanding his floors, and I'm just like bullshitting with him. And I was like, I'll stop talking now. I know I'm dim.
I mean, dude, you might be the fucking, what's that movie where the janitor writes on the chalkboard?
Yeah, right.
You might be that because, like, dude, if you really were like a dullard, I don't think that this dude would be like even talking to you.
Well, dude, like all these guys in these Ivy League schools, they are studying this shit all the time about people, other different kinds of intelligence, different people's minds. And if some of these people can't talk to themselves in their minds, they're at MIT, they invented this thing like 5 or 6 years ago called alter ego. And they're getting ready for AI to come about.
Yes.
And it's a plug-in. It's a wearable that can read your mind. And they're like up in like the 80%. Like, if you want to pause it, I'll show you the fucking trailer for it. They created a thing that can actually read people's minds.
And it's like, so they don't have to them?
They don't have to, I don't know how it works.
Yeah, hold on. I'll watch, like, it real quick. Hold on.
Dude. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. They've been working on this stuff. And I know Epstein, and remember when we looked into that whole bunch of dudes that, like, the fucking
Bechdel?
No, the
Oh, Rand Corp?
No.
Damn.
The parties that they were having. The Epstein party with the pictures of all those guys.
Edge, some shit? Yeah.
They're all MIT Edge type dudes.
Dude, now,
they're trying to fund this thing. This thing's reading your mind based on subtle whatever, sub-vocalizations. But, like, sub-vocalization is what it is called when you are learning how to read. So when you're learning how to read, like, real dum-dums like me will actually read all the words to yourself.
Yeah.
Like, other people can just scan it and move through the information and remember it.
Really?
Yes. So that's people that didn't get stuck in talking to themselves. So they can read faster than us. Yeah.
So there it is. So that's why they're in MIT.
That's the trade-off, yeah.
I'll take that, dude. I mean, books are gay anyway. The thing that I can't, like, I physically can't comprehend, it's like you're walking through the grocery store and it's adding up the total of how much your shit is.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, are people really not thinking on that level?
I don't understand how the thing works. This could all be bullshit to go try to make some money.
Yeah.
Who the fuck knows?
But there, like, there's legit studies that, like, people don't have inside voices in their heads.
Yeah.
And, like, it's a majority?
Yeah. I don't know. Like, my fucking head's fried.
So the fella's crazy?
My head's fried, yeah. I'm talking to myself. I'm out here talking to myself.
I do it to the point where, like, it annoys me.
I do it to the point where I have fantasy realms where everyone hates me and doesn't want to talk to me anymore for multiple days on end.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it really is a double-edged sword. You could think of nothing and just blow through books.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ. Yeah. I,
like, people that don't have sublocalization can read without, like, daydreaming.
Oh, dude, I'm fucked.
You know how, like, you could read and, like, you'll read a word and then you'll start thinking shit?
Yes.
And those thoughts are verbal.
Yes.
So, like, if you think you can't read, you can't do both.
I can't. Anytime I try to read something, by halfway through the page, I'm gone.
They say there's a tip to put on music.
Like Mozart.
or put on Ave Maria, slow down 500%. Think about it. So there was a cyber attack on the Met Opera.
How?
They're trying to like turn this into some kind of thing with the war. And well, that's what I was saying. The Frenchman said that this thing that the United States is doing with the Ukraine, this proxy war type thing.
Yeah.
They did it with China and Japan before they got into World War II.
Talking about like raping Nanking and shit?
They did an embargo around Japan because of what they were doing in Nanking and all that.
Holy shit.
See, I didn't know this stuff. I was like, dude, I don't remember them teaching us that in high school. And he said they teach it at like the Naval Academy.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, dude, history class. I think we were lucky if we got like just past World War II and if it was, it's only the hits.
Yeah, well, it just fucks me up because if there's non-state actors trying to do mass social engineering,
yeah,
it's working. They just ran a fucking, everybody got their legs waxed for fucking 2 years.
Thank you for using that.
So
monetized.
It's just like a crazy thing. Like they did the cyber attack and then they're like, oh, maybe it's because like they were playing like Carol the Bells, a Ukrainian song, like that kind of shit. It's like, dude, come on, man.
That was their reason?
No, they're just trying. The media is just trying to like aim it at Russia.
Oh, Jesus Christ. It's crazy. Yeah.
Like every hacker's from fucking Russia.
Yeah. Were you the one telling me they just did another event 201?
Yeah, they did one in South America.
Like, do you
know? It's called Sears.
Like what it is though?
It's for children.
Oh, yeah, respiratory. You told me that.
Respiratory, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, dude, if there is
the
no,
CIA is involved in that.
Obviously, dude.
But that's what I mean. It doesn't make sense. These are all like state/non-state actors carrying out warfare. Warfare is when you want to get your enemy to do something they don't want to do. That's warfare.
Yeah.
That's all it is. I might read this fucking art. I might get into fucking war, dude, because
should.
I read this book called Unrestricted Warfare, and I should have read it a couple years ago. Do you remember when I was talking about that one general, and he was like warning us about China?
Yes.
Remember that's Robert Spalding?
Yeah.
I read that book,
yeah.
And I was like, dude, this is crazy.
Yeah.
He said, he was like, check out this book. In the book, he was like, you have to read this. Never read it. Obviously, I'm retarded.
Yeah.
But I did it. I read it. It was written in like not 2000, and they start talking about this fifth generation warfare stuff because they realize that you're not going to beat the Americans at what they're going to do.
No.
Because do you remember, like, I was showing you all those fifth and sixth generation planes?
They're insane, dude.
So people, everyone was building planes, F-18s, everybody had their own version. Then the Americans built this F-22, never really used it that much. And some countries kind of kicked back when the F-35 came out and was like, dude, we're just going to take a fucking L on this.
Yeah.
And we'll catch you on the next one.
You just have to get, like, there's no, you're just making people poor trying to keep up with you.
Yeah, so they started to just, they skipped a whole generation of planes to try to just say, like, fuck it, we'll get the Americans next time.
Yeah.
And they just know that, like, soldiers aren't fighting the next war. And no one knows, no, like.
It's kind of.
So I'm reading this, man, I'm sorry, dude, I'm fucking this up.
I watched Terminator 2, by the way.
Oh, sweet. This book I read on war is like, no one knows that they're, like, we look back in history and go, oh, yeah, that was the war.
Yeah.
First of all, dude, did you know that if you go to, like, West Point and stuff, you learn about ancient wars?
Like, how?
Like, ancient? The Peloponnesian War and shit.
Really?
Like, the tactics. It's fucking crazy.
That makes sense.
It's pretty cool. Anyway, like.
Is this in the book?
Yeah, they're talking about Napoleon.
You should enlist, dude. Hunter Biden did it when he was like fucking 40.
I could do psyops.
Yeah, just join a squadron.
Yeah, they like Napoleon needed money. He had like a plan. Napoleon was like cocky as fuck. He needed a plan. He had money. He needed money, so that was why we ended up with Louisiana.
Louisiana Purchase. Napoleon gave it to him.
No, but that he gave it to him for the money, and then he just went and rocked fucking Europe with all the American dough.
He went fucking hard as shit. I think it was like $4 million in gold.
Yeah, but they were talking about him. He was like a fucking crazy person, how good he was at war.
Yeah.
People were like phased. And I remember reading the book about Stonewall Jackson. He was all psyched about all that shit. But anyway, the people that are in war, they never know. Like when it starts, when it first starts, you don't know what it is.
First popping off,
all brand new weapons, and like the weapons get created. Like everyone goes to war thinking it's going to be the last time.
I was just thinking about that when you told me that because you showed me the videos of the airplanes, And I'm like, dude, how the fuck are you even in military at this point? Because you have no idea what, where anything is or where it's coming from.
But it makes sense. Like, if you think about it, you're World War One, you're Germany, World War One, you got rocked.
Yeah.
What, are you going to go dig trenches and try that again? No. You're going to come out with blitzkriegs. Nobody's waiting for a blitzkrieg. Nobody ever fucking saw it before.
Ultimate surprise.
So that's what I mean. Like, we are at war with non-state actors. There's no end to this war. We don't know who the enemy is. We don't even know when we're getting attacked. Most of it is social engineering. And it's to, and because the goal of war is to get people to do something they don't want to do. So if you have like cognitive biases or like you have, they can feed them to you, first of all. They can give you, they can give you stuff. They can give you like plant seeds in your mind.
Yeah.
Of things you, like, you know.
Pro tips.
You get what I'm saying, though, right?
Yeah, I get what,
like,
you're saying.
You could just be chilling, and then they could, like, through the internet, start persuading you to, like, think of, like, to want a certain outcome in something that you have no dog in the fight.
Nope.
You know what I mean?
I'm real pumped on the World Cup right now. I've been watching videos of fucking soccer celebrations over and over again, and chants. I don't give a fuck about soccer.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know what this is for generational warfare, but they got me on the soccer realm.
Yeah, but if you like, if you read 1984, they're constantly at war.
Yeah,
and it's like a kinetic war, like that means like action, mm-hmm. you know. And they're constantly at war, and in reality, they're just in a psychological war.
Yes.
So like we're being told there's a war somewhere that we need to give all of our money to, and it's very important.
Yes.
And they'll show some footage of it and all this.
It's the reason why the money changers, that's how the money changers got money, is because they would use wars as a way to attain wealth. So now what you're telling me is, and the money changers, they hate.
This makes me want to go hide in the Hermitage.
They hate having to spend a bunch of money. Yeah. We said the same stuff about getting waxed. When all that shit first came out, we're like, dude, why would you release a real bioweapon when you can just use the media that you own and say there's a bioweapon and then give them some bullshit-ass shelf shot that Fauci and Gates had a thing to? Like, now they can just do it all online. They're not actually killing anyone, and no one knows who it is, and it's nonstop money. Like, Instagram, full of ads. Facebook, full of ads. Everything. Candy Crush, if you play that. I don't play it. I don't smoke cigarettes. I'm not a single female in her 40s, but they all do that.
You don't eat hot shit.
Yeah, exactly. But they, like, all it is now, like, they're getting people to fight on the internet, and then they're getting them riled up enough to buy 2,000 mules. And, like, it all goes somewhere. Like, this is getting people angry and thinking that, like, amount of people who either, like, buy shit that, like, bug out bags.
Oh, yeah. Everything, I want all that stuff.
Everything could be completely fine. And, like, you literally just unplug the router. Go outside. You walk around. Maybe you have an effed up neighborhood. And you're like, this is real gay. But if you were, like, I was watching a documentary on an elephant whisperer. Bro, that man's not worried about the Ukraine. That dude's out there chilling with elephants in crystal clear water. There's nothing going wrong. And that's probably why all the fucking people in the Amazon, the pygmies and shit, civilizations probably come and go. And they're just sitting in the woods like, you guys are fucked. We're literally just chilling in paradise, and you're making the weird.
They're the original Adam and Eve, dude. You saw the movie.
Obviously.
I mean, that was another thing that's crazy. Is like when people started going, I was watching that that one lecture about like the history of the Ukraine, and they're talking about the Carol of the Bells, that song, the Christmas song.
Yeah.
It's actually just a springtime jam, an old pagan jam that was like in and around Kiev back in the way days.
Really?
Like in 900.
So you fully finished this Yale seminar on
I'm done that one.
Ukraine.
And like the end of it, the dude's just kicking it off with the Carol of the Bells jams. But that was like 950. That was back when I was showing you that they were worshiping the Holy Foreskin with St. Catherine of Siena.
You know what
I mean? It's like we're talking about people that are wearing the Holy Prepuce on their finger as a wedding ring with Christ, who also could be fake. From the movie I was watching.
I mean, dude.
So I'm gone, bro. Like, I left the building.
You talk about fifth generation warfare. Amazon Prime Video is ruining everyone right now. You got H2N just putting blacks in a fucking tailspin.
Oh, yeah.
They're
gotcha.
They're the original Jews. Kanye West losing his mind. And then you transfer over to the Jesus Christ. What's it called?
Creating Jesus.
Creating Christ.
Or Creating Christ. Yeah, sorry.
Dude. I got 3/4 of the way through it, and I was just like, you know what, man? Not for me. And I just turned it off. I was like, dude.
Yeah.
Just not no,
they were
not
saying,
before Christmas.
They were like, St. Paul was, I was like chilling, just like, yeah, whatever. And then they were like, St. Paul was actually an intelligence agent for the Roman Empire. I was like, okay, I'm in.
Yeah. Strap up. Yeah.
Let me tape my eyelids.
Dude, I was grouting. Yeah, I was grouting on the floor when I was listening to that. And it was no joke. Like, I think I had maybe 25 minutes left. And I was like, I get it, I do, but I'm just gonna turn this off.
Yeah, I'm good.
I remember thinking I was like hot shit when I was younger, and I'd be in religion class, and be like, what about Hindus? When they die, where do they go? It's like, oh no, they're cool, yeah, they're cool.
Big brain stuff.
And I didn't know that there's some Indian boys over in India. Like, what about Christians? Where do they go when they die? To Krishna.
yeah, it's fucked up, man. It's fucked up. It's fucked up what all this is, the double-edged sword of having the internet. We thought it was free, but we're on the battlefield.
No, it's not, dude.
Yeah, we're on the battlefield, dude. That's all it is.
We don't have the fucking internet, because when we had the internet, we were mentally stable.
Yeah.
Well, and we were chilling, watching whatever document. It's crazy documents.
But this is what I'm trying to say to you is, like, now we're on the battlefield. You didn't know that you were at war.
Yeah.
You remember, like, all that joking about the meme wars?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the new form of warfare.
Yeah, I mean, it is. I can't argue with it.
It's like beyond advertisement and propaganda. It's like way past that. We don't have words for what we're in right now.
True. And
because people aren't, you can't tell me that the world is right.
Not even in the slightest. It's real confusing, right?
Like, everyone,
to describe it.
No one's doing so hot, I would say, upstairs.
No.
You know?
And that's why I would say, like, for someone who went through a worldwide shutdown, guys like me and you, it's fucking crazy, but I couldn't imagine if, like, you spent the amount of stress on your mental, if, like, for the last 2.5 years, everyone was going to die, everything's fucked.
Oh yeah, you got to take care of your mind, dude. Yeah.
Putin's fucking killing innocent Ukrainians, yeah. And then now you're back into like RSVs here.
Yeah, the Russians are taking Viagra.
That's weird. They do that every time. I don't understand why it always goes to like weird rapes and stuff.
Well,
like
the Israelis are really good at information war, and they like claim that they carried out the first AI war against Hamas.
What?
Yeah, so they did like a whole social media campaign where they lied, they tricked everyone.
Like an Arab Spring type deal?
No, that might be the first. That might be the first case of fifth generation warfare.
True.
It might be, but the Israeli thing, they ran like a tactic or whatever, and they claimed that it was the first AI driven. War, like piece of warfare, like it'll go down in the books like, oh, that was the first time that they used AI.
Yeah, it's like the machine gun of World War
I. But that's just the first time. Yeah, for real, that's the first time. Like once people find out that there's a weapon to make people that don't want to do something do what they want to do.
It's what George Floyd was.
It's well, and then the thing is, like, back in like 2002, like they took over Palestinian TV stations and put on porn.
That's fucked.
That was a tactic.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, if you're fucking still addicted to porn, take care of your mind. This is a war.
Yeah. It is weird. Like, there's a, like, now that the Kanye West.
It's like the Havana syndrome.
Yeah. Now that Kanye West gave everyone a few things to chew on about the Semites.
Yeah.
There's dudes who are going, like, the big thing right now online is, like, man on the street interviews. And there's a dude, like, a PragerU type. I don't know what fucking.
What's that?
PragerU?
No, what's a PragerU type?
Just, like, you know, just a dude like that. And they're out there. Oh, and Berkeley's campus, and mind you, I have my qualms with Berkeley. I don't necessarily give a fuck about it, but they're asking him, like, what are your thoughts on Israel? And, like, they're freaking the fuck out, saying, get the fuck out of here. We don't support them. And then, like, talking about Palestine, he goes, well, you don't support us. How do you think you would do if you were queer in Palestine? It's like, bro, like, can you guys please, like, just chill the fuck out? Like, you can't be getting hated on this hard and then going there, like, well, you think we're bad. they treat gays pretty bad too. It's like, dude, you guys are like sore losing on another level.
Just yeah, right. Chill
and beat it for a little bit because you're in some hot water. And you might get punched by someone from UC Berkeley.
Yeah. Yeah, it's bad. It's bad out there.
It's like that shit with the little girl in Iran or Iraq or whatever that is. Like that's what we were talking about a few weeks ago.
Oh, with
like,
the hair?
The hair. That Man. Shit pops off and it's like, dude, it doesn't go across the internet. No, like just out of luck.
Yeah, people like have to try to get numbers now.
Yes. Like, so you had like Liver King made a whole entire business plan.
Well, it's a campaign. It's like the Balenciaga campaign. Like they put a couple years into that.
Yeah.
Did you know there's a Zoolander 2?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think it was later on.
Yeah.
You're probably on a bigger and better film.
Exactly.
Yeah, it is it is crazy though, because like they at this point, like we were saying, you used to be able to just watch whatever documentary you wanted, cool as shit. Kind of just
nothing ever pissed me off.
Just
I never
around.
Watched anything and got like pissed off, and now there's a ton of shit I'm not even gonna look at.
Yeah.
You know? Something's up.
They got you. Gotcha. Yeah, but like it gets pushed out there by someone or something, because we were just out in deep waters hanging out, swimming, nothing wrong. And then all that shit, it was like a huge ocean, and then it got put into a little tiny fucking pond, and now we're all with all the fucking fishermen. We had our own little patch.
Well,
we're chilling.
I'm kind of fascinated with the thing of figuring out some people don't have internal monologue, which... Still fucking melting my head. But, and then Tom has this.
What do you do when you have to shit? Like, you thinking about it?
What?
Like, you don't
Are
have
you an. Talking yourself through this?
I'm just saying, like, if you don't have an internal monologue, like, you're not, like,
no,
sitting on your desk, like, damn it.
They just
shit.
Must have something else. I don't believe that this is a thing. I think it's just that, like, some people have a lot more practice, like, hearing the voices.
Yeah.
And are open enough to talk about it.
Yeah.
All of these, like, survey type things I don't trust that much.
Yeah, I guess you're quote unquote crazy if you have voices in your head. What are you saying about Tom?
Tom's always like, he's got this fan, like not a fantasy, like what do you call it? Like a fucking, he's like got like a nostalgia, like he like longs for like one kind of like a cultural
nostalgia, yeah.
Entertainment type thing.
Yeah.
Like it seems
late
like
late nights.
It's yeah, like late night shows and all this kind of stuff, like something that everybody watches. But he can't be alone in that. Even though, like, you're only calling it nostalgia just because it's no longer a form of media.
Yeah.
But, like, so, like, media, like, reflected what was already happening. So, like, back in the day, before they created TV and all this stuff,
yes.
Everyone was just, like, telling each other stories anyway. And yeah. Then when radio came out, they're like, oh, we'll do this on the radio.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't, like, create the concept of, like, telling stories for it.
Yeah.
So there was, like, cultural myths, like, collective myths. But, like, if you break that down, that's, like, taking away someone's religion. If you break down, like, there's no collective, like, oh, did you see, like, the fucking Simpsons?
Yeah.
It's over.
Yeah.
You know, like, nobody can agree on, like, nobody, like, experiences the world in the same way. Like, a collective story type thing that's, like, outside of your family and your local friends or whatever. It was a cool thing that they had going on for a while.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, it doesn't matter who was running it. It's just got fucked up. Sometimes three generations is enough.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, dude, it seems like as far, like, for millennials, like, nostalgia is everything, bro. That's all they care about. Like, it's, I don't know how to, like, boomers like talking about back in my day, and millennials love shitting on boomers for hitting them with the back in my day thing, but, like, you give anyone, like, you give any millennial a little taste of nostalgia, it's game the fuck over.
But that's just everyone.
I know, but, like, they used to, like, shitting on the boomers. Like, it's now happening to millennials with, like...
Yeah, it happens every time.
It's fucking hilarious.
It's every kind of people.
But, yeah. Like, the member barrier, it's just...
They used to think it was a disease, like a mental illness.
What, think about the glory
like,
days?
Like, longing for the past like that.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of is.
Yeah, it is.
It definitely gets some people, but, like, it seems like they might be throwing some shit out there. Like, they're doing it on Instagram now where, like... You can put up a message, almost like an AIM away message, and every human being on the planet is just like hitting the old AIM away messages like a joke. But like, it's just like they're putting this shit out on the internet now, and it's making everyone do the same fucking thing. It's driving me insane, dude. Like they did at first.
Yeah, I'm not on the socials. I don't know what you're talking about at all.
everyone, they're just like,
they're doing like old stuff.
They're like, now on Instagram, you have your direct messages, right?
Yeah.
And there was just your direct messages. And then you have your stories, which are just your stories, right? And now if you go into your direct messages, you can now make a custom note that sits up top. You can scroll through everyone's custom note as if you weren't jerking off hard enough on fucking Instagram. You can now see if someone's like, I'm eating dinner. It's almost like it's fucking Twitter.
Oh, okay.
But it's just like, it's fucking nonsense. And all these people, like, they're, like you're saying, they're on a battlefield, but they may as well be fucking cat and fodder.
That's what they are. That's what I'm saying. They're pawns.
You think everyone's pawn?
Everyone's a pawn right now.
Yeah, it's from...
Like, you, like, unknowingly, dude, we were handed the internet for what it is, almost free.
Yeah.
For what it does for your life. And I remember, dude, do you remember when I tried not to do it? Remember when I tried not to get a smartphone and I didn't want to do, like, and then I eventually had to have email for work?
Yeah, I mean, remember, like, I was like fucking 17.
Yeah,
18.
You were young, but I fought this at the beginning, dude.
Yeah.
But like, so anyway, for free, they kind of just gave this to you.
Yeah.
Almost free. Whatever your internet.
And you made it smart as shit.
You made it smart as shit. Well, what happened was they handed you this thing. And whether they knew it or not, or you knew it or not, you stepped on a chessboard.
Yeah.
And you are either white or black. And this is what's going on. And you don't know it. And you don't know who the enemy is. And you're just getting told to go two steps up, one step over. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Like, that's it. And like, that's all you're doing. And eventually, they're going to take you out. And, like, what do you got to do? You got to get a whole nother life set up that doesn't involve this.
Yeah.
Because eventually, this is going to spiral out of fucking control. And the internet's not going to be a safe place for anyone.
And you become an elephant whisperer.
Yeah.
If you watch a documentary, dude, it's cozy. You watch it in subtitles, but...
Because at this point, I don't see how this is entertainment.
It's not. And then you got, like, everything's driven by, like, the AI and shit. And, like, back in, like, when Facebook was going through all their troubles of, like, bullying and this shit, like, they trained the AI to get, like, do more of the shit that has the most engagement, and it was all fucking hate. So, like, it was all, it's like when you're, like, at work and you have a bunch of coworkers and you're all fucking chilling. And then out of nowhere, like, it's just you and some other dude and you're like, I can't stand that one guy. And then, like, every day now, it's like you're talking shit on this guy.
Let's not do that right now, please.
But I'm saying, like, it's fucking, like, that's what they're doing. Like, like you said, like, you go on the internet and get mad now. I used to go on and chill all the time and literally just have fun. And now it's, you're always, like, they just push it at you that tries to get you fucking angry for whatever reason. You can't focus on shit. Like, there's stuff where I'll see, like, the trans and kids and stuff, and, like, I'm fucked up. Like, I can't have a productive thought for the next, like, 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And, like, there's, like, if you start reading in the comments, you're like, how do people think this is fucking normal? And you're losing it. When in reality, they could all be bots. Elon Musk had Twitter, like, a lot of these, like, a lot of the things are, like, you're literally, like, you used to do the smart guy or whatever the fuck the AIM Autobot was, you could talk to them, now they're just fucking other profiles that are commenting shit that would get you pissed off.
Yeah, all the AI, the AI isn't gonna do anything, like, I think it's just kind of like I don't think it's, like, the end of the world that they create this AI stuff. I think it's what people do when they react to it. So, like, these people that don't have inner monologues or whatever the fuck kind of people are out there, like, there might be a lot of legitimate NPCs bumping into walls, getting hit with, like, paragraphs from AI and being like, oh, that's what's happening? Like, they're just waiting for commands, dude.
If they get Neuralink and start giving these people inside thoughts, that'll be crazy. Because, like, if you don't have, like, an inner monologue going,
and I can't believe that's a
and
thing.
You're on psych meds, like, bro, what is that like? Because the only battles I have are with myself in my head.
I'm Don Quixote at night, bro.
Like, to have nothing, I feels like it would be like fucking Nirvana.
That's what I thought. I started listening to this stuff, and I was just like, wow, if that could be a drug.
If you laid down at night and nothing was there.
If you could give that to me, I mean, holy shit. Things start spiraling out. I just pop a pill. And I just get to be like everyone else. I get to turn this dude off.
It has to be psych meds. That's what it is.
Yeah.
Like, that's definitely what psych meds are. It just turns off the guy inside.
Maybe. I don't know. The other guy gets mad.
Yeah, they don't want you to do it. That's like, there's been times where, like, I was real tripped out for a while on like the simulation and all that stuff. And like, I'd be looking at fucking buildings and just like in the car by myself, just out loud, like, this game's getting real fucking weird, dude.
Well, the white pill for me with the fucking figuring out that we're on a battlefield is like, oh, so, okay. All right. Well, maybe we could fight. You know what I mean? Like, if they're going to start fucking with my head, it's like, I don't know if I could somehow take what happens to me and spin it around.
You don't need that.
I'm just saying, like, if I could.
Dude.
If they're hiring.
I think 20 years from now, if you went down that road, it would be whatever the guy, who's the dude who dropped the nuke? That speech would happen.
Like, I have become it. Death.
Yeah. You don't need to figure that out. We can just have a good old time and not unleash that on someone else. That would make people, you ever see Alex Jones played it before in Star Trek? There's a little orb that gets onto the ship and it starts making everyone fight each other.
Yeah.
That would be you. We don't need that. We don't need everyone fucking fight each other. And the way you get rid of that orb is through positivity.
Yeah,
you
start
complimenting it and the orb can't stay around anymore. And who's the main guy? Captain Kirk. Get out of here. That's all it is, dude. These people are on the fucking net. They want you to get mad. Like, because if you just peruse and you're just chilling, there's no money, there's nothing, and they don't like that. Everything on there is to get you fucking pissed off and horny for whatever reason.
But
at this point, Instagram is literally to laugh at stupid shit, get pissed off, get horny.
It is pretty crazy how fast, like, the idiocracy level of all that shit came about within, like, a decade.
It's Ow My Balls times 1,000.
It's like within a decade.
Like Ow My Balls, I almost get at this point as opposed to like watching endless twerk videos. Like I used to go on break with this one operator and he would just sit on his phone and watch twerk videos and hood fights. It's like, bro, like anything else you want to do on break instead of that?
Thunder thoughts.
Do you enjoy?
It's just girls fighting.
Oh, yeah. There's something about chicks fighting where, like, I just can't watch it. I can't do it. Like, I can watch, like, World Star Hip Hop used to have fight comps.
Yeah.
I would always fast forward through the fucking chicks fighting. I just can't see the Sweet Angels get fucking mad at each other. By the way, speaking of fucking AI, all the artists are getting super pissed off that there's fucking AI drawings now, and they're, like, revolting.
Why?
They're saying it's total bullshit.
Well, I mean, what do you mean? Because they'll be out of a job?
I would say that. I guess they're saying it's not real art. Personally, if you want to fight this war, don't duct tape a banana to a white piece of paper, and then we wouldn't have this. Like, if we were having good at, like, if we didn't have this, what is it called? What kind of art is that? Is that modern art?
You could just say modern, sure. Yeah.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. Like, you can't.
I mean, if it's just, if you walk in and it's already there, it's probably modern. If you watch the dude duct tape it, I'd say that's more of a performance art.
Okay.
You know? So I remember going to school and they were like, oh, dude, we got this really famous guy. He's like a real big deal painter. And the dude's name's Robert Ryman. And I'm like, all right, cool. And he's going to come and talk. And they like popped his painting up. It was just a white thing. And I was like, what?
The whole thing?
The whole thing's just white. And like, there's definitely like some brushstroke texture stuff going on. Yeah. But I was like, okay, nice. let me look into this CIA file.
Yeah, it does suck. Like, I feel for the people who are actually good at drawing and like AI is kind of doing this because it's the same shit. Remember when?
Yeah, just imagine like imagine sitting there being like, imagine like being able to grok the fact that you could do that. Like you could, it's kind of like if you're like a 7-footer, you're like, I could probably dunk.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? It's like that. You're like, I could probably do that, and they're like, oh, we don't do that anymore. Don't worry about that.
Is that how it was when you went to school?
That is what it is. I mean, mostly if you go to any of these like modern art shows and stuff, it's like there might be some stuff that's actual like some of the old like art craft, but most of it's like video. It's crazy. Stupid, it's like Marina Abramovich type shit that you'll see. It's like the Balenciaga stuff.
Dude, you know what was real weird? Yeah. Remember we were in New York that one time when we watched that video the chick showed us?
Yes.
That was very similar to the fucking Balenciaga shit.
That's all what that is. It's a lot like Zoolander.
It literally, like, it 100% is. But the funny shit about the AI art is, like,
I watched a thing that was like Mr. Blue Sky, ELO, with AI generated from the lyrics. It was pretty cool.
What are they talking about?
you know, the song.
The song, but did they freestyle over Mr. Blue Sky?
No. They take the lyrics, and then it's AI images.
Oh, they paint it.
The AI makes, like, images, and I was like, oh, this is pretty chill.
Stop that, human.
I'm just saying, they don't make music videos anymore.
So you're going to be a transhumanist here. Yeah, the funny shit
is... The transhumanist agenda is real, though.
Obviously, dude.
It's totally real. I mean, if you watch that alter ego thing...
Yeah, but like...
That's just them. That's with them with their training wheels.
The thing that sucks is, like, you could be an artist and be good as shit. And, like, remember when you try to put your friends on, like, hey, maybe you guys could draw these NFTs, you make some money, and they fucking flipped?
Yeah, they got real pissed about that one, yeah.
So the new shit...
They don't make any money.
None.
They don't make any money, and, you know, some of them do. Like, my boy EJ makes money, but it's like, I'm just like, yo, man.
Here's an idea.
Try to just get some bread.
But, dude, the thing that's really
pissing I'm on a paper off, chase, dude. Been that way since I was, like, 13 years old. Like, I need to eat.
The thing that's pissing them off now, though, and it's happening online, like, they had Instagram. They had all their sick shit and all the liberal stuff they love. And then AI came out with self-portraits.
So trendy.
Different self-portraits.
So liberal.
The chicks jumped on it, dude. Like, chicks are changing their profile pictures to the AI version of themselves.
Oh, yeah, I know.
So AI did all these fucking...
But they're, like, hotter, you know what I mean?
I know.
It's kind of like with an anime twist.
Little bit. And, like, this is, like, if there is a point where they want us to merge into, like, some machine, like, you can never die. Look, you already have your AI.
Dude, stuff. I've had this before, and this is going to be embarrassing. Like, this is... I've had this thing before.
What?
Where... I don't even know if I want to talk about this.
I mean, are you doing dark psychology on me right now?
Got you. Gotcha.
Did you actually just do dark psychology on me?
So, like, have you ever seen some of those porns that are, like, CGI?
Yeah, sure.
But, like, they're, like, the newer, like, ads will come up?
Yeah.
And then, like, you know that, like, scanner...
When I'm doing counter research.
You know, you know that, like, Scanner Darkly, like, movie where... It's kind of like the DMT.
Yeah.
So, like, in the real world, sometimes I'm like, whoa, is that real or is that CGI? And then I started thinking kind of like in a paranoid way, like, at some point, am I not going to be able to know what's real from the screen and what's real from real life? Like, are people going to start to, like, morph?
Definitely.
Like, is my visuals going to change? You know what I mean?
I mean, dude, if you're old, like, it's the same shit, like, when you're coming back off mushrooms, when you're like, dude, am I back yet?
Yeah, it's
if
like...
If you always have fucking, like, the goggles on and you're always in VR, you could take off your goggles in VR of taking off your goggles in VR, yes. And you'll get lost. You'll never know if you're fucking back or not. You'll be in a fucking hellscape.
And you're like, is it over? Is the DMT over?
That's why I can't fuck with the Neuralink. I can't do any of that shit because... There was a point when I was like, you know what's right.
I'm
like,
zero body mods.
Yes. Like, there's a point where you're like, I know I should be back in this thing. I don't know what it is, but I know what it feels like. And right now, I'm here.
Well, I'm in my Earth suit. And however we got here, I'm good with that. I don't think we need to fuck with our Earth suits. I'm kind of comfy with, like, just trying to keep this thing going.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought one of my buddies at work was going to die. I'm all fucked up.
Yeah, now he's okay.
I'm, like, I'm looking at that Earth suit, and I'm looking at the clock, and I'm hoping we see Christmas.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So this shit gets fucking crazy. Like, if you're walking around and you, like, start to see people different than they are, you don't know if they're, like, CGI.
Yeah. I mean,
Do you get what I'm trying to say? Like, just it would just happen in your mind. It's not... I'm not saying that it's real.
This is what the next level of this warfare could be.
Yeah.
Because you could steal people. And they could be in their house the whole time.
Yeah, or I could be talking to a friend.
Yeah, literally.
That's not real.
Dude, it's fucking... That's why I don't fuck with this shit. Because, like, you can fuck with me on the internet and get me angry. But I at least can turn that off and just, like, go away. If I'm... the minute I'm in my VR and I take my goggles off...
Buddha box.
Oh, I'm back? Am I back? And then you try to do it. It's fucking terrifying.
Yeah, that whole thing of... At that point, like, we live in a simulation type thing. Like, it would be crazy if, like, you die and, like...
Think about it all the time.
So, like, you die and, you know, you don't go to the light. Who knows? That could be bad. Go to the light, whatever. But then it's just, like, it's over. And then out of nowhere, someone just pops the fucking headset off. Think and they're like, bro, how fucking crazy was that?
Dude, I like this is like a daily thought for me.
Well, I mean, I've read this thing. I was like looking at I got sad a couple days ago. I was looking at the girls online again, like fucking trying to get a date or whatever.
Right.
And like one of the chicks was like, we're all just walking each other home. And I was like, damn, that's sick.
Yeah.
Like, that's all we're doing.
I think about it all the time. You know? Like, I'm in a capsule in a spaceship going somewhere and to pass the time because it takes an uber long time to travel space.
Yeah.
I'm just doing this.
That would be sweet. If that, then, like, if that was
you
what
wake
was...
up and you're like, dude, you got like another year to get there. It's like, all right.
If we were in like frozen stasis to get to a longer destination.
We're just chilling in some fucking tube where.
That might be what Earth is. And the real travelers are just our genes.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. Like,
and our consciousness is collective.
This is
and
where
we just
like,
got to keep it going.
I stare at shit and go, something move. Something
yeah,
move.
I mean, we're on strange. A mothership.
Yeah. But like, I'm just in the house by myself and I'm staring at like a broom and just like, fall if this is fucking fake.
That's magical thinking.
This is a computer
David thing. Bowie did this for like 4 years with meth.
Dude, I like, that's why.
Well, like pure cocaine and milk and peppers.
Yeah. I mean, dude, I could see like.
He had giant black Nubian bodyguards.
That's sick. Like, if, and I could do, like, that's the thing. Like, people can call him crazy. Yeah. Be that famous. Be that famous and be like, yeah, this
be
makes
that famous
sense.
For a week, dude.
Yeah, this makes sense.
Come on, man.
If you're that famous and you're walking around, everyone fucking loves you.
He was in Zoolander.
David Bowie was?
Yeah.
RIP, did do some supposedly weird satanic shit at the end there, but, you know, can't judge a man for that stuff. Yeah, I've no idea. The other thing they're doing with AI is, like, now it's, like, making the sentences. I guess that would help with your Neuralink stuff for thinking. But, like, now they're having, like, AI that can have full-blown conversations with you, and you have no idea that it's a human.
You're saying you had no idea it's not a human?
Yes.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so, like, you could just think it's another person on the internet. They're that good now.
Yeah, I'm not going to make it. I should just turn it off.
It's just not for us.
Yeah.
Like, that's the internet's there. Too much tomfoolery. We got voices in our head. Don't need it. If you don't have voices
in
your head.
Yeah, like, I don't have a great show for this time. Like, I would have been great in, and I mean, back me up here, trench warfare.
Yeah, you'd be ideal.
Industrial Revolution, factory.
You say that, too, but Lionel Messi's 5'7".
I mean, soccer's always.
The goat.
That's all. Soccer's always for us. But I'm saying, you know, just Reggie dudes that aren't, you know, super talented with the ball.
Yeah.
The football.
Yeah.
Like. I'm saying wars.
So yeah, that's what you think you're built for.
Civil War. For World War One.
Yeah.
World War Two. I'm probably getting rocked.
I mean, most Navy SEALs are in the mid fives.
Yeah.
They're not big dude. Like, you can't have a big target.
They're just not even putting dudes in the planes anymore.
That makes sense.
They're shifting out of that. I mean, they have basically invisible planes. They're moving away from the stealth shape. Like, you know, they make stuff. Like, okay, you might not really think this is fucking shocking.
Yeah.
Because you're young.
Right.
So, when do you think the stealth bomber was invented?
Like, 95?
81.
Oh, shit.
So, they showed Top Gun.
No stealth bomber.
I think they're like F-14s.
Yeah.
Like.
Dogfighters.
Dude, when that movie came out, the United States was already like. Doing stealth runs.
Jesus.
Out of the skunk works.
So, like,
so like
they got now is retarded.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, people have stopped any state or non-state actors that wanted to come at the American population to use them or to fight, to get them to do something or have a war with them. They're not using kinetic military action.
Yeah.
It's a non-military war, but it's still warfare. That's the thing that people can't wrap their head around.
Yeah.
Is that, like, were like in your head because they constantly hit you with like Top Gun Maverick and they kind of hint at it in the movie Maverick. They don't know who the enemy is.
Oh, really?
They don't name the enemy. And so this invisible enemy has been floating around in the predictive programming swamp for like fucking 3 years.
Yep.
While everyone just keeps getting crazier and crazier.
Yep.
And doing weirder and weirder shit. And it's not all about spending money. Like, it might just be mass social engineering for some reason we don't know yet.
Yeah, they have, and that's why I legitimately think that they're going to bring aliens. It's the only way. It's the only way they can control the whole world is if they had, like, because this, like, people are too cool with each other. We're like,
I don't know,
what
man.
Was
I
that
mean,
thing
if they want to end the Fed or if they want to fucking take down the dollar and switch over to a central bank digital currency and then tell
they're
us.
They're trying everywhere.
And they'll tell us that our dollar's not worth anything and then. People will get riled up and try to fight about that. But if you broke up the population enough, before that. I don't know. I mean, watch Money Masters. Go back and watch an oldie but a goldie, Money Masters.
I'm halfway through it. Yeah. Anytime I watch it, it's just like...
I was talking to Fed about it earlier, about the tally sticks. Like,
they're sick.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Yeah, you know? I just get, like, once I start watching that, it's like, damn, dude. Like, almost every bank started with lying with how much money they have, and, like, you're going to turn around and audit people like us.
It's yeah, so I have a brown back. I have a $5 brown back that I found in a factory that Kev was demoing.
What's a brown back?
You didn't get to that part in the movie yet, but they have greenbacks and brownbacks from Abraham Lincoln just printed his own money and broke out of the...
You found it there?
Yeah, we found it in a desk. Yeah.
Down on the Fourth and Race, right?
Fourth and Race, yeah. Yeah,
fuck.
It was cool. It's cool, man. And, like, Lincoln came out with these... Like, Andrew Jackson was like, fuck you to the central banks. Obviously. And, like, then there was, like, this great time. And then they created, like, a whole civil war to try to get them back
in. They did the same shit with Napoleon.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
The Rothschilds tricked them. They made him think he lost the war. They all fucking went crazy on the banks.
You're
they
talking about
on the dollar.
Waterloo?
Yeah. Dude, seriously. We need to get back there. It's crazy. And Money Masters, literally any dude who just says, yo, your shit's kind of gay, I'm just going to make my own, you get killed.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's like, do you have the gayest form of money where it's you win all the time and we lose? And I'm tired of being sore.
For real.
I'm tired of being a sorry person. I want to make money just like you guys. The Romans said usury was illegal. It's probably why Caesar got killed.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy when you start thinking about it. Hopefully they're not the guys that are trying to take us down, because they're formidable opponents.
Yeah. I get real bummed out when I think about this stuff, but at the same time, I just wish there was a part of the internet. Like, it shows you all the bad and all the ways you could be fucked. Give me a site that shows, like, what good stuff, what the good guys are up to. Or are we just not allowed to know their plans? Like, you have, like, Event 201 and shit. They're doing this stuff.
I thought they were good guys, and they had to, like, secretly just post sometimes.
You know, that gets taken over. But, like, they have Event 201. And it's like, dude, we're doing this to you. Yeah. And the bad guys give their whole plan. Are the good guys?
They're
just
like Bond
smart?
Villains.
Literally.
Yeah.
They're 100% Bond villains. And doing
the guy weird. That wrote Bond was like, he was an intelligence agent. And he like was kind of like, those Bond movies are like a warning. I really do believe that some of these guys are connected enough to intelligence. Definitely the Nolan brothers.
Yeah.
There's in some shit. Because if you look at their complete movie package, there's a lot of predictive programming in that.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, like, there's a lot of these guys, like, Goldfinger, is it?
Yeah.
Goldfinger?
Goldfinger was Awesome Powers.
No, Goldfinger is Bond. Goldmember
is Awesome Powers.
Yeah. But, yeah, that was like a warning, because, like, there's no gold in Fort Knox. So everyone freaked out because we had all this gold at the end of World War II, whatever. We have all this gold because they... took all the gold from the United States citizenry. It was illegal to have gold. It was fucking insane. You used to be able to take a bar of silver, go to the mint, and they would make you coins out of it. Then they made that illegal. There's no silver. So they took all the gold. They confiscated all the gold. It's the biggest theft of all time.
Hid it in the Philippines.
They took it to Fort Knox, and then the Europeans bought it. So then...
Oh, my God.
Yeah, they took it all. So, like...
paper.
Everyone kind of thought that the gold was there when they had that, when they ran on the gold reserve.
Yeah.
Like the gold backed dollar.
Yeah.
That was a farce. There was no gold. Fucking Reagan put a commission together to try to find out, you know, what the state of the gold was, to see if that was an option to go back to the gold standard. And then they were like, oh yeah, nah, that's not happening.
So they switched us over to the fiat.
They took our gold. They took the actual gold from all the American citizens. And then at a very low price, and then they raised the price like 15 or like 30%, probably something like that. And then they fucking sold it off to the Europeans for cash.
Back to the Rothschilds. Dude, it really is. I never knew when I was watching. I didn't know J.P. Morgan was just a fucking Rothschild.
I've told you that before, Pierpont.
Yeah, just a Rothschild lieutenant.
Yeah. It was a British banking house.
Like, do people ever get into, like, how they blackmail? Or is it, like, same old, same old?
I don't think they're, like, I think it's just I think the whole system is just, like, an institution at this point.
Right.
And, like, the Rothschilds of today are just, like, running fucking Terramar or whatever the fuck they're up to. You know what I mean? They're just doing weird. They're doing the weird. But I don't think they're like dated. There's like probably two of them that are actually like in banking. You know?
I mean, maybe. It is like, you can't be that lucky for that long.
Like, it's not luck, bro.
Yeah, you're never chucking up an L ever. You're just, it's nothing but W since fucking Napoleon Bonaparte.
No, they legalized their scheme.
Right.
Yeah, that's what they did. They have a foolproof plan. If you give me a dollar, I can lend out 10 of those, even though I'm only holding one.
That would, I mean, dude.
They've been doing that for at least since the Fed.
Could you imagine if there wasn't, like, there was no interest?
I don't know. What was that book I sent you today that I saw at the French's? Hold on.
Yeah, I mean, when I was watching that, they were talking about, like, interest being illegal. It would make shit go way faster.
Yeah, I might read this book. Jews, Christian Usurers, and the Spread of Mass Expulsion in Medieval Europe.
Just Rowan a little Doran. Coffee table book.
Just a little something light. Oh my no God. Return.
Yeah, I mean, that's a heavy read. I think we should just watch, like, I'm going to watch Terminator 2.
No, watch Die Hard.
Oh, yeah.
Get ready for Christmas, bro.
I started Die Hard. I didn't finish
it. You didn't like it?
No, I just didn't finish it. I, like, fell asleep while watching it. Now, I don't know what I'm going to do. I have to do something about this lower back. I can't lay down. I have to fucking do something.
No, I mean, let's go. Let's go.
What?
Let's go to Shane's thing.
Okay. All right, now, oof, we'll see. Oh, my God. Well, we'll check back in a little bit. Now that we're back, baby.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I had mental health problems.
Yeah, and then we're back. Who doesn't?